Good morning all. The term innovation sounds easy, but implementing it in a professional setup takes a lot of perseverance and long-term commitment. And that is the reason why many companies falter when it comes to innovation. The main challenge is to balance the autonomy versus control equation. More of autonomy and less of control breeds innovation. But where to draw the line is a major cause of concern for most organizations. The culture of innovation should percolate down from the higher-ups, but the implementation should happen from bottom-up, as the employees who work at the grassroots levels are better equipped to spot opportunities for innovation and implement them effectively. To inspire inspiration from the arts and the sciences, the organizations could look at one specific form of art called the Impressionism. There is so much to pick up from this example. First of all, the movement itself began as a conscious and innovative effort by its proponents to defy the set norms. Initially, the vociferous critics rejected it completely, but the Impressionists persisted. They conducted many exhibitions all across, and it came to be called an innovative or revolutionary style of painting. Persistence and belief in what you do is very important for innovations to succeed. Secondly, the style propounds a fading barrier between the subject and its surroundings. The inference is this. Every organization has both external and internal factors that influence it. Segregating the problem and viewing it in isolation could lead to incorrect interpretations. Looking at the big picture with a porous boundary between the problem and its environment will help arrive at a more practical solution to the problem. Thirdly, the paintings depict mundane scenes and visuals but embody modernity. In an organization, there is a better way of doing every routine task. The idea here is not to discriminate between large and small innovations. Both are equally good for the organization. In the Impressionist style, loose brushwork gives a feel of spontaneity and effortlessness, despite the fact that the paintings emerge out of careful contemplation. This is one of the important aspects of this style. As Mr. Drucker himself would put it, all effective innovations are breathtakingly simple. Innovation is hard work, though the outcome looks simple. It is a result of careful contemplation of the current situation and ways of improving it. So, to conclude, the arts and the sciences are immense sources of inspiration if the organizations know where to look. Consistent effort at innovation is what differentiates one organization from the other. And for as long as the organization doesn't lose sight of this, it can succeed. Thank you.